Welcome to this presentation on using the WAVE Toolbar. My name is Greg Kraus, University IT Accessibility Coordinator at NC State University. So what does the WAVE Toolbar do? It does a number of things, but today I want to highlight three aspects of it. First, it will check web pages for accessibility errors. Second, it will show you your document structure. And third, it will linearize your page to show you what order it would be read in by a screen reader. So the WAVE Toolbar is a Firefox add-in. And here I have an example page that has a number of accessibility errors with it. To start using it, I'm just going to come up here and click on Errors, Features, and Alerts. And when I do that, it'll give me a message telling me it found 19 accessibility errors, and it'll show me graphically where those things are. So for instance here, I can see that there's missing alternate text for this image. And again, I'll see that same icon used in lots of places for missing alternate text. But even for images where you do have alternate text, it will show you what that alternate text is. In this case, it shows me that the text here is horizontal line graphic, which in this case is probably a bit excessive and it really should have been a null string. It'll show me other errors, like here is again alternate text missing from an image in this case. Over here it shows me that I have form labels missing. It'll even detect if you're potentially just using font stylings to make your text look like headings instead of using an actual heading. Some other cautions it will give you. This icon here will tell you that there's an event handler present to make sure that you're handling that event in an accessible way. And you'll also see the eyeball indicating that there's some invisible content and to make sure that you're handling that appropriately, because if you ever do CSS display none or visibility hidden, it'll actually completely hide that from screen readers and they won't be able to access it. Scrolling down the page, we can see a couple other things it will show you. Here it gives some other warnings for problematic link text. Anytime it detects that you've done click here or something like that, it's just giving you a warning to give a bit more contextual link text there. And here it'll show you me, it's saying I'm using this as a layout table because it doesn't detect any headers or anything in here. So this is really giving me some information to say, well, I know I'm not using this as a layout table, so now I know I need to go back and correct that. I'm going to reset the page to show you some of the other features. So if I click on the structure order, this will show me some of the underlying elements in my page. Like for instance, this menu is constructed with an unordered list, or I have two items here that are an unordered list as well. Let me show you a page that has a bit more semantic markup on it to show you what the structure order looks like in that case. So here I have this same page just written with better semantic markup. So when I click on structure order, it'll show me things like here's a heading 1, here's a heading 2, again it shows me list items, again heading 2, and so forth. Let me come back to this original page and I'm going to reset it again. Now I'm going to click on this text only option, and what this will do, this is kind of similar to turning off your CSS but not fully. What this is doing is it's showing you what order a page is actually going to be read in by a screen reader. And this is important especially when you have a lot of nested tables and you're using those tables for layout. So this, you can just scroll down the page and you can see here how this table is going to be read, how it linearizes it. Again, this page isn't using a lot of complex tables, but this is a useful tool if you are using a lot of nested tables. I'm going to go back to the original page now. One last thing I'll show you about this. The WAVE Toolbar, this exists as an add-on in Firefox, but there's also a web-based version of this, and sometimes it's useful to send your page to the web-based version. Occasionally, you'll get an error. It'll say, WAVE found an error while you're running this within Firefox, but you can't find the error visibly on the page anywhere, and sometimes then it is helpful to actually come over to this menu and choose Process at wave.webaim.org. And when you go here, it'll give you a similar type report, but it lays it out just a little bit differently, so sometimes if there was a hidden error, you can more easily find it. Here's a link to install the WAVE Toolbar. I hope you found this tutorial useful and you'll be able to use the WAVE Toolbar in making your web pages more accessible.